Hi students, this is Ramalakshmi, physics faculty. Today our topic is acceleration, motion in a straight line, video number 3. Already I had completed 2 videos on this topic. First part, distance, displacement, and in second part I had discussed speed, velocity, instantaneous speed and instantaneous velocity. Still anybody not watch that videos means once check that 2 videos. Today our topic is acceleration. So once recall speed and velocity. What is speed? The rate of change of distance is called speed. The rate of change of displacement is called velocity. Instantaneous speed. The speed of an object at any particular instant of time is called instantaneous speed. The velocity of an object at any particular instant of time is called instantaneous velocity. Speed is a scalar quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity. Okay, now coming to our topic, acceleration. What is acceleration? So first of all, we know distance, displacement, speed, velocity, all these are physical quantities. Acceleration is also physical quantity. Acceleration is denoted with the letter A bar because acceleration is a vector quantity. The rate of change of velocity. The rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. So acceleration A bar is equals to change in velocity by time. So overall change in velocity is denoted with delta V bar by delta T. So acceleration A bar is equals to delta V bar by delta T. So delta V bar by delta T, change in rate of change of velocity. We know velocity is a vector quantity. Acceleration is also a vector quantity. What is the CGS unit of acceleration? Centimeter per second square is the CGS unit. And the meter per second square is the SI unit of acceleration. And dimensional formula of acceleration, here only length and time is there. So L power 1 and T power minus 2, this is the dimensional formula of acceleration. The rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. Acceleration is a vector quantity. SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. And the dimensional formula of acceleration is L power 1, T power minus 2. Let us take one example to understand acceleration clearly. When an object is moving along a straight line path, initially when time is equals to 0, velocity of the object is 2 meter per second. And after 2 seconds, velocity of the object is remains constant, 2 meter per second only. At 4 seconds also, velocity of the object is 2 meter per second only. So here, object is moving along a straight line path. The direction is same and the magnitude of the velocity also constant. This kind of motion we know uniform motion. When an object is moving with the constant velocity, then the velocity of the object is said to be uniform velocity. So in this case, let us take any 2 time intervals. What about the velocity remains constant? So we know acceleration A bar is equals to change in velocity by time. So from 0 seconds to 2 seconds, the change in velocity, final velocity 2, initial velocity also 2, and the change in time is 2 seconds. Then what about the acceleration? Acceleration is equals to 0. Why? Because velocity is constant velocity? Is equals to zero, then acceleration also equals to zero. Okay, let us take another example. Initially, time is equals to zero. Object is moving with velocity 2 meter per second. After 2 seconds, velocity of the object changes to 4 meter per second. And in next 2 seconds, velocity changes to 6 meter per second. So, in this case, what about the acceleration? So, first of all, let us check what about velocity. Velocity continuously changes with respect to the time. So, acceleration is equals to change in velocity by time. In first 2 seconds, change in velocity. Final velocity minus initial velocity by change in time. Here, final velocity 4 meter per second. Initial velocity 2 meter per second. And change in time is 2 seconds. So, what about the acceleration in this case? 1 meter per second square. Acceleration is equals to 1 meter per second square. Okay, let us check. In another 2 seconds also, here 4 seconds, in another 2 seconds also, here final velocity 6 meter per second, initial velocity 4 meter per second, change in velocity 2 meter per second and time 4 minus 2, time is 2 seconds. Then what about the acceleration 1 meter per second square? So, here 1 meter per second square, here also 1 meter per second square. That means acceleration is constant here. Acceleration is constant. When we get constant acceleration, here check in between any two time limits, change in velocity 2 meter per second. Here also change in velocity 2 meter per second. So, the rate of change of velocity is constant. In previous case, the rate of change of velocity is 0. There is no change in velocity. Object is moving with a constant velocity. But in this case, velocity of the object changes at the same time. The rate of change of velocity also constant. So, when object is moving with a constant change in velocity, then acceleration is a constant. Okay, now let us check by taking another example. When time is equals to 0 second, object is moving with velocity 2 meter per second. And in another 2 seconds, velocity changes to 3 meter per second. In next 2 seconds, velocity changes to 7 meter per second. So, in this case, velocity changes. Velocity is not constant. Velocity changes. And the time limits are equal intervals of time. Let us check the acceleration. In first 2 seconds, acceleration is equals to change in velocity by time. So, final velocity 3, initial velocity 2. So, 3 minus 2 by time 2 seconds. So, 1 by 2 acceleration of the object is 0.5 meter per second square. And check the acceleration in next 2 seconds. Final velocity here 7, initial velocity 3 and the time is 2 seconds. So, 7 minus 3. 4 by 2 acceleration 2 meter per second square. So, here in first 2 seconds acceleration of the object is 0.5 meter per second square. In last 2 seconds acceleration is 2 meter per second square. Means acceleration is non-uniform. Motion is non-uniform. The velocity of the object varies and change in velocity also varies, then acceleration of the object is non-uniform. So here the main points. When velocity of the object is constant, means uniform motion. In case of the uniform motion, change in velocity is zero, then acceleration of the object is also zero. And when change in velocity is constant, velocity changes, that means the motion of the object is non-uniform, but the change is constant, then acceleration is constant, means acceleration is uniform. When change in velocity is constant, motion of the object is non-uniform, but acceleration is uniform. And when the change in velocity is variable, then acceleration is also variable. That means both the motion and acceleration, these two are variables. These two are non-uniform. So when velocity variable, acceleration also variable, then both the motion and the acceleration are non-uniform. When an object is projected vertically upward direction or freely falling motion, but acceleration due to gravity is acting in downward direction. So in freely falling motion, acceleration is nothing but acceleration due to gravity. So here what is the initial velocity of the body? Zero. The direction of the velocity in downward direction only. But gradually the magnitude of the velocity increases. Here the only reason to increase the magnitude of the velocity is because of the acceleration due to gravity. In uniform circular motion, magnitude of the velocity is constant and the centripetal force is acting towards the center. So because of that centripetal force, centripetal acceleration is acting towards the center. So because of this centripetal acceleration, the direction of the velocity at every point changes. Draw tangential line. It represents the direction of velocity. So at every point the direction of the velocity changes, but the magnitude of the velocity is constant. So in this case, the direction of the velocity changes because of the reason of the acceleration. And in case of projectile motion, when a body is projected by making an angle, the path followed by the body is a parabola. So here, object velocity continuously changes, but the velocity both in magnitude and direction changes. So the magnitude of the velocity changes. At the same time, direction of the velocity also changes. In case of projectile motion, when a body is projected by making an angle theta, but acceleration due to gravity is acting in downward direction. So because of this acceleration due to gravity, the magnitude of the velocity, at the same time, direction of the velocity also continuously changes. That means by using these three examples, acceleration can change velocity either in magnitude or direction or both magnitude and direction. Average acceleration. The total change in velocity to the total time is called average acceleration. So average acceleration is equals to total change in velocity to the total time taken. And next, instantaneous acceleration. The acceleration of a body at any particular instant of time is called instantaneous acceleration. So when time is very very small, the acceleration of the object is called instantaneous acceleration. So instantaneous acceleration is equals to, here time is very very small. So limit delta t tends to 0, delta v bar by delta t is equals to dv by dt. So differential form, this one dv bar by dt is the differential form. Instantaneous acceleration is equals to limit delta t tends to 0, delta v bar by delta t is equals to dv bar by dt. In given problem, velocity is a function of time. We want to calculate the acceleration, then use this formula dv bar by dt. But maybe in given question, we don't know velocity. But in given information, position vector and the position vector is a function of time. Then how can we calculate the acceleration? So take that formula, instantaneous acceleration is equals to dv bar by dt. Again, we know velocity means rate of change of displacement. So, in place of v bar, take ds bar by dt, that is equals to d square s bar by dt square. So, double differentiation, where s bar is the displacement vector or position vector. When we know displacement vector as a function of time, use this formula to calculate the acceleration. A bar is equals to dv bar by dt and that is equals to d square s bar by dt square. Maybe we don't know displacement, but we know velocity vector as a function of position. So yes, v bar is a function of position. Then how can we calculate the acceleration? So take acceleration is equals to dv by dt into multiply and divide with the dx. So when we multiply and divide with the same value, there is no change. So now dx by dt. Here dx by dt, what we know? The rate of change of displacement is called velocity. So in this place, substitute velocity v bar into dv bar by dx. So now acceleration is equals to v bar into dv bar by dx, where velocity is a function of position. Then use this formula to calculate the acceleration. A bar is equals to v bar into dv bar by dx. So here velocity is a function of time, and here position vector or displacement vector is a function of time. And here velocity is a function of position, dv bar by dx. So in today's video class, what we learn? Acceleration, average acceleration, instantaneous acceleration and different applications of the acceleration. In next video class, I will discuss the numericals on velocity and acceleration. Okay, thank you students. Have a nice day.